So, Alan, where's the best place to start writing a dictionary?
With, well, I would say at the A's.
Well, it seems in lexicography, the art of dictionary writing, they like to start with M.
Oh.
The theory is that they've got their I in by the time they get to A.
So you mean the M's are probably rubbish?
That means they've started with the I, then.
A, no, no. When I said I, I meant E-Y-E, and you thought, possibly for comic effect, but if so, disastrously, that I was saying I. That wasn't what was happening at all. It was completely something else. It was one of those laughable misunderstandings, and I used the word laughable quite wrongly. So, anyway, from dictionaries, we turn and plunge into the heart of darkness. Name, if you can, the subject of the three-volume book whose first volume is entitled The Long Years of Obscurity.
The career of Phil Collins.
I did a show once of Phil Collins. Well, not just me and him, there's like loads of people on. And he did a song called Where's My Hat? And he was wearing his hat throughout. It's ridiculous. Do another song, it's rubbish.
Book about the word obscurity before it got famous, how it was beaten by its adjective father and left on the doorstep abandoned by his mother, and then it was the only noun growing up in a house of verbs.
Is it?
The verbs were always going out doing lovely things because they're doing words, and poor old obscurity was stuck inside suffering from asthma. After school, it was surrounded by quotation marks, got beaten up terribly, and then one day it entered into a reality TV show and it became very famous, and it was much in demand and used to describe all the people that leave Big Brother House.
Absolutely amazing. God, I wish that were true, Ronnie. I really do. That
is it Chairman Mao?
It's not Chairman Mao, The Long Years of Obscurity. It begins with D. It's got two Ds in it, in fact. That's your clue.
The double diamond. The double deckers.
It's the sort of thing that railway enthusiasts, they always try and make their steam train sound more exotic than they
that's
are.
That's very odd. Railways.
Do you actually know this? Because it is my local station. It's about Didcot.
It is about Didcot! How extraordinary you knew that.
Well, Didcot is only a station because the people of Abingdon are so snooty, they decided, we can't have a station. Don't want a station, all that noise, all this steam, all that sort of stuff. So the local Lord Wantage said, no, no, we won't have it, we'll have it up the road in Didcot. So they built a station next to the power station you see there, which is the third worst eyesore in the country. It was a country life thing. You know what the first one was?
People, public people, working class. Nearly, because poorly groomed servants. The ill-bred ponies. The old Blair fellow.
If I find out you've been intercepting my mail, I should. So. Let us know what was.
Wind farms. It was wind farms.
Oh, really?
Yeah. But the power station was designed by the same guy that did Liverpool Cathedral, so...
You must have some points for knowing about Didcot.
Do I get a little point for the railway?
You get 5 points for the railway and your astonishingly moving story about the early abuse suffered by the word obscurity. You also get the telephone number of a therapist. So, no, wonderful.
Too little too late.
A Didcot, though, is the small, oddly shaped bit of card which a ticket inspector cuts out of a ticket with his clipper for no apparent reason. It's a little-known fact that the confetti at Princess Margaret's wedding was made up of thousands of Didcots collected by inspectors on the royal train.
That is...
Princess Margaret just got the second best of bloody everything. Yeah. I'm afraid... Let's get some Didcots together for the girl.
One on a young girl's wish list. A big white wedding, lots of Didcots.
That particular fact I give you is not so much a fact as a made-up thing.
Oh!
It comes from the book The Meaning of Lift, which, oddly enough, was co-written by Douglas Adams and the producer of this programme, and he somehow smuggled it onto my card. anyway, there you are. Didcot does have, and this is so typical of Didcot, the second oldest yew tree in the country. Not the oldest, no, the second oldest. 1,600 years old, though, that's quite an old yew.
Third ugliest, second oldest.
Yeah. Always the bridesmaid, Didcot.
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos.